Hello, I'm Michael Genhart, the author of Accordionly, Abuelo and Opa Make Music, published by Magination Press, the children's imprint of the American Psychological Association, and illustrated by Priscilla Burris. Accordionly was inspired by what? The instrument, the accordion. Listen to the different sounds it makes. There's the keyboard, there are buttons, and these are called bellows. Hey, did you know the accordion is also called a squeeze box? Guess why? When you squeeze it, air is pushed out of holes through reeds in the accordion, and it makes different sounds depending on what keys you play and what buttons you push. The accordion. Now, I also wrote Accordionly because my father played the accordion, as you see in this picture. He's holding the accordion, he's standing next to his brother, and in front of his parents. Both of my grandparents were born in Switzerland. My dad and his brother were born in the United States. That makes them first generation Swiss Americans. And my mother, you see her here, she's the taller of the two little girls standing in front of her parents, my grandparents, is of Mexican American descent. Her grandparents were born in Mexico. My grandparents and my mom and my aunt were born in the United States. So that makes my mom second generation Mexican American. So I wrote Accordionly as a story of a little boy who brings the two cultures of his family together through the music of the accordion with the help of his two grandfathers, Abuelo and Opa. Now, I bet there are a number of you that also come from families where two cultures come together. Maybe different languages are spoken in your home, too. And I hope that you embrace all of the richness that comes from those cultures coming together and those languages coming together. And I hope that you're inspired to really celebrate your family, and all the things that make you uniquely you. I hope you're inspired by this book, Accordionly, Abuelo and Opa Make Music. So let's read it together. The accordion is a funny looking instrument. Is it a little piano? Some kind of harmonica? Huh. My abuelo plays the accordion in a mariachi band. When they play ranchera music, he hoots and hollers louder than the rest. Abuelo, is that you? Isn't that fun? That's called a grito. It's a fiesta every time he sings. And whenever we visit, my abuela makes tamales and arroz. They're really yummy. My opa plays the accordion in a polka band. When they play, he belts out a yodel that makes the windows shake. Opa, is that you? Isn't that funny? He's the only person we know who yodels. And whenever we visit, my oma's lechuchen and hot chocolate make us feel right at home. Abuela and opa always bring their accordions when they each visit me. Music and singing fills our home. Sometimes I get up and move like a flamenco dancer. Other times, I do the polka. The first time my grandparents were all together, one side of the table was really quiet. Can you see? Guess what side was really quiet? My grandpas couldn't speak each other's language, so they didn't say much to one another. They said please and thank you a lot, but not much else. We spent the day together in silence. We exchanged glances, but not words. We listened to the birds sing, but we didn't make a sound. Look at that little boy. He doesn't look very happy, does he? My parents noticed the silence too and wondered if something was wrong. ¿Qué pasa, Esmam? Abuelo simply grumbled. ¿Vas islos? Asked Dad. Opa just scrunched his face. Can you make a scrunchy face? The silence made me sad. Look. He looked sad. That's when I had an idea. I think it has something to do with accordions. I asked Abuelo to get his accordion. Then I asked Opa to get his accordion. At first, Abuelo and Opa just stared at one another. But then they both broke into laughter. Abuelo strapped on his accordion and started to play La Chariada. Opa and I listened, and Opa watched Abuelo very carefully. Opa began playing the yodel polka. Abuelo and I listened, and Abuelo watched Opa very carefully. Soon they were playing along and singing together. Look, don't they look a lot happier through music? How music can bring us together. Isn't that fun? I hope that's true of your families, too. The blending of yodels and hollers broke the silence. Music filled our house once again. Uh-oh, look what's happening. Just like an accordion. Look, watching Abuelo and Opa made my heart sing with happiness. With all my family together in harmony, accordionly. Look at that. They're all together having a great time. So thank you for listening to Accordionly, Abuelo and Opa Make Music. I thought it would be fun to talk about an activity that you might do with your family. We're all spending a lot of time these days indoors, at home, away from school. And so I thought, what might be an activity you might want to do with your family? And I thought, how about making a family tree? Now, a family tree starts with a trunk. You all know what a tree looks like. And different branches, right? Lower branches, upper branches. When you put together a family tree, you start with the lower branches. That's where you go. And your brothers and sisters, if you have any. Above that are branches where your mom and dad belong. See the different sides? A mom side and a dad side? And if they have brothers and sisters, they go there too. Above them, your grandparents. That would be your parents' parents. And then your great-grandparents. And before you know it, you have a big old tree. It's really a wonderful way of learning about your family. You can actually interview your parents and your grandparents and your great-grandparents if they're around. It's a nice way of learning about your family. You can ask them, for example, what were you like as a kid? What were the things that you liked to do when you were my age? So, and it's just a really wonderful way of spending time with your family, and I hope for all of you, you're able to do that during this time. So thank you for listening to Accordionly, Abuelo and Opa Make Music. Bye for now. Bye. Bye.